Adequate notice of this January 23rd, 2023 regular monthly meeting of the Cranford Board of Education provided on December 13th, 2022 by a media notice posted in the boardroom, Lincoln School, and communicated to the Star Ledger, the Westfield Leader, the Office of the Township Clerk, and all board members. Please rise for the flag salute.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mrs. Carbone.
Here.
Mr. Darling.
Here.
Mr. Dreyer.
Here.
Mr. Hulse.
Here.
Mr. Lynch.
Here.
Mrs. Mallon.
Here.
Mrs. Shaw.
Here.
Mrs. Soltis.
Here.
Mr. Petchow.
Here.
We have quorum.
Thank you. Okay, Dr. Rubin, I'm going to throw it right to you.
Great. Thank you very much, Mr. Petchow. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us. It's fabulous to see all of you. You know, one of the things that I always talk about are community partnerships and just how that really makes Cranford a very unique place, where there are people who genuinely support one another and our organizations are always looking to assist and help the schools. And so we're very excited to honor one of those partnerships tonight, and that's the Cranford Jaycees. Not only do they help our community at large, but they have been instrumental in supporting the schools every year. There's always a time where we've got something on the board agenda we're approving a donation or support that they've given towards the schools. And we are just so appreciative. We want to take a moment at this board meeting to thank them. Just recently, they gave us a very generous donation to our science department. I know Lisa Hayek is here, our science supervisor, and that money will go to good use at the middle schools and the high school. I know that earlier in the year, we thank them from our counseling department, our safety and wellness initiatives. They helped us towards money for PD to become grief-informed schools, as well as our Bullies to Buddies program. And so I know today, representing the Jaycees, we've got Peter Yeskovich, who's the president, and Sean Reese, who is the vice president. I would ask all of us to give them a real Cranford thank you for all that the Jaycees do for us, and Lisa Hayek as well. Sure. Absolutely.
And just to elaborate a little bit, what the JCs donated to the science department, we got a spectrophotometer, which I'm sure everybody knows what it is. That is for our chemistry and our biology classes up at the high school. And then they also did provide us with some electronic balances that are going to be used at the middle school. So we are very thankful for their support of our programs.
Bob, I hope you've got the big wallet.
Great, thank you.
All right. Again, thank you to the Jaycees. And now we're going to move over to our Board of Education liaison reports. We'll start off at the middle school. Let's go over to OAS. We've got Thomas Villarreal and Ava Williams and Ms. Rivera advising. Thank you for your support and being here tonight. Why don't we start off over at OAS? Can I get Thomas and Ava to come on up? Let's give them a nice round of applause, please.
Good evening, Board of Ed members. As we move into our winter months, we continue exciting activities at our school. The esports team has begun their second session with a second Rocket League team and the new Knockout City team.
Ooh.
Hi. Oh, that's not even on. Also, the middle school basketball season has begun with the girls' team being undefeated. We know they will both have a wonderful season. Into the arts, the band and orchestras have had a successful winter concert and playing two extraordinary pieces each. Also with music, the jazz band has had their tryouts and the results have been posted. Congrats to all who have made it. Our OES spring musical, Beauty and the Beast, has begun. It will be fantastic, as the Art Service Corps will be designing and creating the backgrounds. P2E projects are underway with a variety of topics to explore, such as cinema, puppetry, and set design. We are sure they will be great. OES field trips have also been announced. They all seem equally fun. The Student Council is looking forward to our next event, which is Have a Heart Food Drive in February, that will be looking to collect items for the Cranford Family Care.
So, being a good amount into our second trimester, the OAS Student Council has done multiple events to raise money. One of our most recent events has been our January bake sale, in which we have raised a great amount of $329. $100 from our past events will be donated towards Cranford PAL Fund in honor of Will DiGregorio, and another $100 will be donated to the St. Hubert's Animal Welfare Center. In December, the Student Council and other middle school EI classes made holiday cards for the senior citizens at the Cranford Atria Assisted Living Facility. This was well appreciated. Moving on, the OAS Peer Program has been doing an awesome job with continuing to do peer mentoring for the elementary students from OAS and all over town. Along with that, we've been doing various interactive presentations, talking to the elementary school about recent holidays and history months, and by doing so, making their days. Overall, the school has put in extra precautions by recently installing the security cameras.
Well, that's a wrap, and as you can see, we've had another great month here at OES. Thank you for listening, and have a good night.
Thank you, Thomas and Ava. Great job. Very excited to hear all the things that are going on over at OAS. Let's see. Next up, we have Alex and Anthony over at Hillside Avenue School. And Mr. Bregardner, thank you very much for being here and supporting them.
Hello, Board of Education. First off, we hope everyone had a happy and healthy holiday season and we were able to recharge for the second half of the year. The middle school held its annual Winter Spirit Week, where the winning grade earned school spirit points. There was a three-way tie between the grades that needed a tiebreaker the following Friday, which ended with a seventh grade win. Unlike the OAS, our basketball team is definitely not undefeated. The winter concert will also be this Thursday at 7 p.m. The whole music department has been rehearsing for weeks and are ready to put on a great performance. The music teachers were also able to get guest artists as well to help us practice. We hope you can all attend. On the 10th, the incoming 9th graders had an orientation at the high school. It was great to see so many students there wanting to learn more about next year. Mr. Roach and Mr. Sorrentino also came to HAS to talk to the 8th graders about expectations for 9th grade. Our teachers have been doing a great job this year preparing us for next year.
Hello, everyone. My name is Anthony Daniello, and I'm the Vice President of Hillside Avenue. Let's start with school musicals. The fall musical, Haphazardly Ever After, was a great success, and all three shows sold out. The cast and crew all did an amazing job. Despite the success, the cast and crew are already preparing for the spring musical, which was decided to be Mary Poppins. We know this is going to be a great success as well. Are ready? In February, middle school students will be taking both the math and English iReady exams. We have been working hard to improve our scores from the beginning of the year. Our teachers have been doing a great job helping us improve throughout the year. Food drive. In December, the elementary classes held a canned food drive. It was a great success as students from across HAS donated to help out those in need. Seeing a lot of the school participate tells you what kind of community we have here in Cranford. Thank you for your time.
Great job, Alex and Anthony. Thank you so much. And last but certainly not least, we're going to head over to the high school with Gianna. Take it away.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ruben, sorry. So I'm going to start off with our sports. Our girls ice hockey team has been dominating this season. We're so happy that it's their first season and they're doing excellent. We're just so happy that the girls finally have their own ice hockey team, and they're amazing, really. It's astonishing. The boys wrestling team is once again the Union County champs. And we've seen a ton of student support for the boys ice hockey team as well. So we're really getting the students excited for our winter sports. Midterms are starting Thursday, and I'm really happy to report that the teachers are doing an excellent job of preparing the students for the exams. I've only taken the midterms once, so this will be my second time taking midterms in my entire high school experience. But I actually am feeling pretty okay going into them because I feel like my teachers have done a great job of preparing us and helping us organize our notes and everything. As for performing arts, our Into the Woods musical has been working on, you know, set design and practice, and we're so excited for the show. We had our winter band concert, I believe last month, and it went wonderful for clubs. The Girls Who Code is actually going to be working with Girl Scouts in our community to help the girls achieve their coding badge. Our Mental Health Matters Club is doing a wonderful job of helping students in Cranford High School achieve mental health. I go to every single meeting because the girl who runs it is actually one of my friends, and she does a wonderful job. If we're not doing yoga, then we're making glitter bombs, and if we're not making glitter bombs, then we're working on time management. And it's a really fun club that helps not only provide the skills that you would need to be aware of mental health, because it is very important, but it also does so in a very fun and creative way. We had a youth and government interest meeting on the 19th, so students who were interested in government and getting involved were able to attend that. And on March 16th, the Harlem Wizards are going to be playing the CHS staff, so we get to come out and support the staff. And then the Model UN was actually awarded the Outstanding Delegation Award at the YMCA UN Conference in Hershey, Pennsylvania last weekend. So before I wrap up, I just wanted to say thank you to our janitors and our teachers. They really have done such an amazing job this year keeping our schools healthy and happy and safe. So with that, back to you, Dr. Rubin.
Can we give one more round of applause for all of our liaisons? This is not an easy thing to do, but they do it really well. They've got a career here, for sure. Thank you very much for keeping us up to date on all the wonderful things that are happening in the schools. It's really nice to hear about all of them. Our focus is always on safety and wellness of our students. And so to that end, we've got lots of initiatives and programs that we do every school year in each of our buildings. One of the things that we are, as a piece of that, is the anti-harassment, intimidation, and bullying programs. Back in 2011 is when the Anti-Bullying Bill of Rights first came out. And as part of that requirement, although they've had some modifications over the years, there is a requirement for school districts to do a biannual report pertaining to harassment, intimidation, and bullying matters. And so I'm going to ask Lisa Burfine, who is not only our director of school counseling, but also our anti-bullying coordinator, to come up and please present to help in partial fulfillment of that responsibility. So thank you, Lisa.
Hi, everyone. The student liaisons are a tough act to follow. not as exciting what I'm reporting on tonight. But before I start, I wanted to give a shout out to Gianna and the Mental Health Matters Club, because I had the privilege of attending that once as well and made myself a glitter jar, and it still sits on my desk. So it's definitely well used. So as Dr. Rubin said, I am here tonight to report on report period one and the cases that we've had throughout the district from September through September 1st through December 31st. Our numbers, as you have in front of you, are, I would say, consistent with what we had pre-COVID. We definitely had less when students were going virtually. My hope is that with the programs and the trainings that we have that we're reporting from this first report period, we don't see an increase in the second half of the year. Usually we do have a slow start in the beginning of the school year as kids are sort of getting used to each other. Certainly with the winter months and being inside for recess and not having that release time as much, we do at times see an uptick in HIV allegations. The one thing I will say, which is very nice, is that HIV founded, there was only one of all of the cases that were alleged from September to December. So that was good news. We do further educate our students and our faculty and our parents on what HIV is. That's a part of every year in hopes that they understand the difference between there are lessons that are given on what's bothering versus what's bullying versus what's harassment, and what potentially would hit those three prongs to make something founded. What I do notice also, as you look at the protected categories, in the above cases, they all don't equate because although there are 18 cases altogether, they don't all have a distinguishing characteristic for what the allegations were. The cases that we have particular categories in, I will say, are different than we had a few years ago. So I can't say that we are consistently, let's say, offending the same people or alleging against the same people. We don't have a consistent pattern, but what I can say is for these particular cases over the last couple months, all of the grade levels in every one of the schools is addressing that in their own way at the schools, whether that's the particular lessons inside the classroom or through the social studies classes or through assemblies. So not only is it what they normally do every year, but now they're proactively doing other things in response to the particular cases that are happening this year. As far as on the second page, like the trainings and programs that we have, they're very many and very numerous in such things as we've done in the past, including things like the Cranford Parent Academy. Obviously, every school has their own school safety team. Those are considered trainings. We have the No Place for Hate designation that we consistently maintain every year after we earned it 2 years ago. Different schools have individual things to their schools, such as the Words of Wisdom at Hillside. We have the Kindness Families at Livingston Avenue. And then there's obviously individual theme weeks that go on at every one of the schools, such as Inclusive Schools Week and Week of Respect, Peace Week, Red Ribbon Week. These are all programs that we have, like I said, that go on consistently throughout the district. The counselors themselves do individual lessons within the classroom, specifically reflective of social-emotional learning, which obviously help support any students, whether they're the potential victims of HIV or to help kids be upstanders to call out HIV when it's there. So those lessons surround, obviously, our six principles of full value, which we are still going strong on, including the five core competencies like self-regulation and self-awareness. So those are consistent throughout the year. I will say, going back to what Dr. Rubin said about the Jaycees, we have had an opportunity this year. They so graciously and generously funded the continuation of us becoming a grief-informed school district, which equates to last year, we went into the sixth grade classroom. Someone from Imagine, which is a center for coping and loss, went into the classrooms for the sixth grade and taught them how to cope with loss. And that doesn't mean just a loss of life. It could be a loss of friendship, a loss of socialization, all things that the kids experienced through COVID. And that even that helps in combat in harassment, intimidation, and bullying. We also partnered with another woman, Connie Palmer from Imagine, who is bringing a Bullies to Buddies program to our schools this year. And that is obviously specifically targeted at kind of teaching kids a new way to have a reaction to handle someone who maybe come at you with some unkind words. So it sort of empowers the students to be stronger and to be more resilient. So that's going to help us as well. And hopefully, like I said, keep our numbers down for the second half of the year when we usually do see an uptick. So we'll have to wait and see on that. And I'll be reporting to you again in next September. Other than that, that's my whole report, unless anyone has any questions.
Anybody have any questions? Or good. You want to make a comment? I was going to make a comment. But you can go first if you like.
Please.
I just wanted to, just make a singular kind of comment. So as a board, and we have two new board members this year, HIV is something that I think the whole state, but, on a local level, we all kind of struggle with, as I know you do.
A bit.
but I just wanted to make a comment that's one side of it. And the other side that, I think as board members we can never take too lightly is the amount of work that you do and everybody underneath you do to put all these programs and put all these clubs in place and to always have the other side of the HIV is one piece of it, but how we, you can't fix it, but how you counteract it to the best of your ability. And since I've been in this room, the amount of programs, the amount of classes, the amount of clubs, the amount of conversations that have been happening, they seem to multiply every single time you're here. And I know that the liaisons are very hard to follow up. I agree with you there. But I know sometimes it almost seems like you're saying the same things again. And I didn't want you to feel that way when you walk into this room. Me personally, as a board member, I really appreciate the amount of effort and the amount of work that goes on behind the scenes to make each student at every grade level feel confident that we're walking into a safe environment every time they walk in. I mean, that's utopia. It doesn't happen. And these kind of actions from children are always going to happen. But the amount of effort that goes into counteracting it or educating and not punishing children is just, it's amazing. And I just wanted to really just say thank you more than anything. So thank you.
Thank you. I did want to just say in response, I appreciate you saying that we do have a lot of programs every year. We do a lot of the same things. We obviously do a lot of new things. But when I look back, obviously, even just 2 years ago, like the landscape of what our children are faced with every day, it's changing. And so as much as we have these programs, we are obviously always searching for new things, and we are addressing and readdressing and new addressing, and the principals honestly are tireless in, okay, this is our issue this year, how are we going to not rest on our laurels of, but we're addressing that because the kids are faced with all kinds of new problems every day. And so with everything shifting and the landscape shifting, we keep having to do more, and so we try.
Yeah, and I just want to echo Mr. Petchow's comments and also thank you. I think, the law's been around for a while. It's had, some changes over time. It is not a perfect law. It is not. I don't know anyone who says it's a perfect law. But the intent behind it is 100% what it should be. And we take that very seriously. It's not just compliance. While we are compliant, we legitimately want to make sure that every kid feels good about themselves, that knows how to handle, adversity, that makes sure that they're in a safe, comfortable environment, because that is every kid's right. And so I know sometimes when people may be involved in an HIV situation, you've got a lot of these strong words because there's all these legal terms because it came out of the legislature of what an HIV may be, right? There's a statutory definition of what it is. And so, yes, we're compliant in terms of going through the process and making sure that if it's supposed to be HIV based on the statutory definition, then determined to be. If it's not, then it's determined not to be. But to be honest, really the bulk of our time is spent on, regardless of whether it's HIV or not, what do we do now to help both of these kids on either side, whoever's in conflict or in dispute or whatever it is? How do you provide supports to kids who are struggling and the recipient of unwanted actions or behaviors? And how do you support them? And then also, how do you take these students that have made very poor decisions in how they're behaving to other folks and maximize the chances that never ever happens again, and that they understand it of why they shouldn't do that, right? What, like how you can be empathetic, how can you look at the situation a different way and maybe act and hopefully act differently. So we do take a look at each and every one of these cases. We talk about them for long periods of time to make sure that we're not only providing appropriate discipline if necessary, but even more importantly, what are those therapeutic responses? And I know, Lisa, that you spend a lot of time with the principals talking over these situations and making sure that we're customizing the response based on that situation. And I love the fact that you did mention, when we start to see trends, that's when, principals and all of us start to think, all right, what is the program we need for this? What do we need to do? Is this a full grade? Is it a class? How can we all sort of share those learnings with others? It really is a very difficult position, but a very rewarding and productive one, because we do provide a lot of assistance to kids and hopefully change their trajectories if they're on the wrong pathway. So I really thank you for what you do. It's not just compliance. It's like anything with Cranford, it's all about heart and helping kids. So thank you.
Okay. As part of the biannual statutory law that Lisa mentioned earlier and Dr. Rubin covered, at a regular public meeting, we have to open it up to any members of the public who would like to speak regarding this biannual public HIB report that Lisa just presented earlier. Seeing none, public hearing on HIB information is closed. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Lisa.
Great. Thanks, Lisa. John, I wanted to go back to, I know you had mentioned, you know, the upcoming spring production and that we just had the band concert that was just held recently. I was able to attend that one in the new auditorium, and I just have to tell you, it was, the kids were fantastic. The kids sounded fantastic. It was a wonderful show. I'd be lying if I didn't every once in a while find myself gazing up at the ceiling and just smiling, but I was still taking in the music. But altogether, it was wonderful. It was very nice to see them in there. It looked fantastic. It was really great. So Bob and everyone else, thank you for making that happen. It was very special. And you could tell the kids really enjoyed it as well. So it was fabulous. Great. It's tough to, when you go to those shows at night, you're all, by the time I get home, I'm still like moving around. Everyone's like, go downstairs. Okay. Also on our agenda is the calendar for the 23-24 school year. We had it as a draft at the last board meeting, so it's here for approval. And then if the board is comfortable with approving that, then we will send that out tomorrow to the rest of the community so that they will have that. Excuse me. And we'll also post it up on the website. And then lastly, I know I teased it at the last meeting, but that was not televised, so I just wanted to share at our February televised board meeting. I will ask Dr. Chinney from the Madison Institute to come and sort of kick off the process and the overview of our strategic planning process. So we have a new five-year strategic plan getting ready to be underway. We're finishing up the one that's in effect right now this year, and super excited to go down that process again. Again, it's everyone coming together. Everyone will have lots of opportunity to share their thoughts and their desires. In a nutshell, right? It's where are we now? Where we would like to be in 5 years, and how do we bridge the two? And we really appreciate everyone's participation in the current plan and look forward to working with the community on the next one. And that is my report.
Thank you, Dr. Rubin. Anybody have any questions or comments for Dr. Rubin before I move on? All right, Bob, all yours.
Thank you. Thanks, Kurt. Real quick, in your packet, and there's a copy out for the public on a table, is the tentative budget calendar for the 2023-24 school district budget. I just want to highlight a couple things. Basically, statutorily, statutes run our due dates. As of right now, the governor's budget address is scheduled for February 28th, 2023. Governor has not necessarily always changed it, but it has been changed in the past. God bless you. If it changes, it does possibly change the submission of our documents. So the most important pieces on that calendar is the governor's budget address, because within 48 hours, school districts are notified of their state aid for the 23-24. Yeah, I always mess up my years because we're so far ahead. 23-24 school year. So you get 48 hours to receive it, then make any changes to your budget after that. The budget is statutorily due to the state on March 20th. We have a board meeting on the 13th, so hopefully we'll be looking to get it approved to submit. And anybody who's heard me talk about it, it's a draft budget. It needs to be submitted to the state for their review. You can change it. They can change it. Anything can be changed technically. But you need to get something into the state by the 20th, and we have a meeting on the 13th. So if everything goes well, we'll be looking to introduce the budget on that date. And then you need to hold a public hearing. When I say you, I mean Board of Education's need to, I always do that, need to hold a public hearing. We will have that scheduled for April 24th. We have a regular scheduled meeting that night anyway. So there's no changes to the board meeting calendar. And I just wanted everybody to have this. We have a Finance Committee meeting scheduled already for the month of February, or during the month of February, I should say, to review it. And we're currently putting it together right now. So any questions on that? Again, it's a tentative schedule for the budget, subject to the governor making any changes to the statutory calendar. Okay, all good. Thank you.
Thank you, Rob. Appreciate it. All right. Does any board member have any communications they would like to share? Okay, William.
Thank you. Just some up-and-coming events. New Jersey School Boards Association, March 8th, 2023, will be the Unsung Heroes at Keene University. Wednesday, April 26th, is a spring meeting celebration and the Union County Teacher of the Year. You all should have received an email from the Task Force for Firearm Safety that was due today. If you didn't get it, let me know. I'll have it resent to you. It's a brief survey that they're asking everybody to fill out. And then I just want to thank one of our new board members, Jess Solsis and Brett Dreyer, for attending the last meeting. So thank you for attending. It was a well-run meeting, so we had a good time. Thank you.
Thank you, William. Does anybody have any questions before we move on? All right, just one more. Anybody else have a communication? All good. All right. We are up to our first audience participation. If anybody would like to come up and make a comment or ask a question. All right. Okay, seeing none, we are going to move on. All right. Patrick, I'm going to start with you. You said you had a committee report.
Yeah. Thanks, Kurt. So the personnel committee met earlier this evening before the full board meeting. We discussed matters of personnel, no pun intended, and we also just touched on the fact that the second round of the staff certificated staff review will commence in February. So more to come after that.
Okay. Thank you, Patrick. No questions for Patrick, I assume? All right. Kristen, I'm going to move over to you.
Thanks, Kurt. The policy committee also met earlier this evening before the board meeting. We reviewed a number of policies, which included a stress SMA policy alert. And those policies will appear as a first read at a future board meeting.
Thank you, Kristen. Any questions for Kristen? Okay. William, you said you had a committee report also? No, it was just a communication? Okay, very good. Thank you. Does anybody else have a committee report or any old or new business? Good. Okay, we are going to move on. Patrick, will you please move the minutes from the previous meetings? Thank you.
Sure. I'd like to make a motion, consideration of the minutes of previous meetings. December 12th, 2022, executive session number 1, 7:02 p.m., December 12, 2022, regular monthly meeting, 7 p.m., and December 12, 2022, executive session, 8:48 p.m.
Second.
Anybody have any comments or questions on the minutes before we move them?
Okay. Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Darling.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Abstain.
Mrs. Soltis.
Abstain.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. We're going to move on to formal resolutions. Terry, will you please move resolutions 1 through 6?
My pleasure. I'd like to move resolution 1, business items. Resolution 2, approved revised budget statement 2022-2023. Resolution 3, board secretary's monthly certification budgetary line item status. Resolution 4, authorizing contracts with certain approved state contract vendors pursuant to NJSA 18A:18A-10A. Resolution 5, approval of travel expenditures. And Resolution 6, field trip destination approval.
Okay, does anybody have any questions or comments on 1 through 6?
Okay. Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Darling.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes. Thank you. Patrick, will you please move resolutions 7 through 9?
Sure. I'd like to make a motion. Resolution 7, HIB decisions. Resolution 8, approval 2023-2024 school district calendar. And resolution 9, workshop presentation.
Second.
Anybody have any comments or questions on 7 through 9?
Okay. Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Darling.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Abstain 7, yes 8, and 9.
Okay. Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Abstaining 7, and yes to 8 and 9.
Okay. Mrs. Soltis.
Abstain from 7, yes to 8 and 9.
Okay. Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Okay. Thank you. Brett, will you please move resolutions 10 through 18, and number 11 is revised.
Yes, I'd like to move resolution 10, approval of substitutes and home instructors. Resolution, revised resolution 11, resignations. Resolution 12, leaves of absence. Resolution 13, contract revisions. Resolution 14, miscellaneous additional assignment 1:1, student assistant winter wrestling. Resolution 15, miscellaneous additional assignment lunchroom. Resolution 16, miscellaneous additional assignment nursing. Resolution 17, approval of volunteer. And resolution 18, approval of clinical intern.
Second.
You take it out? Thank you, Linda.
Thank you. Resolution 11, revised resignations. We have 3 staff resignations that were added. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody have any other questions on anything 10 through 18 or any comments?
1 second. We're having discussions.
Can I get a clarification on who seconded those? Was it Brett?
Mrs. Corbeau.
Thank you. I'm sorry.
Excuse me, I'm choking on my coffee.
Any other questions?
Okay, we're okay. Okay, Mrs. Corbeau.
Yes.
Mr. Darling.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Kristen, will you please move hand-carried resolutions 19 and 20?
Sure. I'd like to move hand-carried resolution 19, appointment, and hand-carried resolution 20, 6-period salary adjustments.
Second.
Thank you, Roseanne.
Thank you. 19, resolution 19, there's a new appointment, long-term sub. It's for a leave of absence. And resolution 20, 6-period salary adjustments. We have 2 groups of 6-period stipends, 1 for a staff member for a leave of absence, a paternity leave, and 1 for a resignation. Thank you.
Thank you, Roseanne. Mm-hmm. Anybody have any questions or comments on 19 and 20?
Okay. Mrs. Corbeau.
Yes.
Mr. Darling.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you very much. Okay, that is it for our formal resolutions. We are up to our second audience participation. If anybody would like to come up and ask a question or make a comment, just please come up and state your name and address.
At least I got through the whole thing.
All right, seeing none, we do not need an executive session tonight, so I need a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, thank you. Appreciate everybody.
Thanks, everyone. Have a good night.